club, bitches.
Now, I've been called a lot in my 23 years, but Donkey of the Day is a new one.
Donkey of the Day for Thursday, August 26th, goes to two people on two different sides of the mass spectrum, okay? One is a man from Texas named James Akers. The other is a father from Florida named Dan Bowman. Let me tell you something, my people. Life is about choices. Okay, that's it. Nothing more, nothing less. Everything in life comes down to a choice. Everything. It's estimated that the average adult makes about 35,000 remotely conscious decisions each day. 35,000 remotely conscious decisions every day. Every day. Okay, and each choice has consequences. There are consequences to every single choice. One of y'all may choose to not brush your teeth this morning. Fine, that's your choice. But if you're wearing a mask, that mask gonna humble the hell out of you. Okay, hell, I brush my teeth every morning, but around noon or 1 o'clock, when I smell the inside of that mask, it reminds me to go kill 99.9% of germs that cause bad breath, plaque, and gingivitis by gargling with that Listerine Cool Mint, which is also my choice to do. And we make choices based on the circumstances presented to us at the time. Which leads me to today's donkey of the day. Mask. To wear a mask or not wear a mask, that is the question. Well, it's your personal choice. Okay, when you are in your own personal space. But what I think folks fail to realize is that we share this space called Earth with other humans and we frequent other humans' establishments. Okay, when it comes to schools and corporations, things of that nature, the people who run those establishments can choose to have whatever mandates they want. They can choose to have whatever rules they want. And you as an individual can make a choice to either follow the rules or not. You as an individual can make the choice to follow the mandates or not. This is why I don't understand folks who act like their civil liberties are being taken away. Nobody is forcing you to do anything. They are giving you a choice, and the choice is simple. Wear a mask, you can come in. Don't wear a mask, you can't come in. Either way, it's your choice. Okay, everybody always having these conversations about boundaries. I have to put up boundaries to protect my peace and protect my energy. True. Well, these schools and corporations are putting up boundaries to protect themselves. Okay, you have to be able to understand that, right? Well, people like Dan Bowman don't see it that way. See, Dan Bowman is a 15-year resident of Dripping Springs, and he's been arrested for assault after he got into a physical fight with a student at his daughter's school while protesting the mask mandate. Let's go to WFOR CBS 4 for the report, please.
In the midst of a steady stream of kids filing into Fort Lauderdale High School on what appears to be a usual Monday morning, quickly turns unusual. Past four school days, this father, who would only identify himself as Dan, walks his daughter Isabel into school only to be denied because she won't wear a mask. This is him before the arrest.
First of all, it's illegal for them to mandate it. It's against the law, against the parents' bill of rights.
Isabel is a sophomore at Fort Lauderdale High. She admittedly is an anti-masker and thinks face covering should be optional. Broward schools resumed in-person learning. Isabel has shown up every day, only for the proverbial door to be slammed in her maskless face. Several dozen classmates line the fence chanting their feelings on the matter. More now on that police report and the arrest. The young lady who you saw walking up to Mr. Bauman in that video, she attempted to grab the cell phone. Well, apparently, according to police, Mr. Bauman grabbed her arm, twisted it back. According to the police report, he's now facing aggravated child abuse charges. As for Isabel, she'll be back at school tomorrow. No mask.
I know this is Florida, and I know the craziest people in America come from the Bronx and all of Florida. But is it ever this serious? Okay, I've seen people follow the rules to a T when it comes to the dress code of nightclubs, all right? These dudes that don't even wear button-ups will go buy a button-up, tuck it in, make sure they got on nice shoes and slacks just to be dressed right for the nightclub. But you're standing outside the school your daughter attends protesting because she has to wear a mask. A mask? The thing that bugs me out about parents who don't want their kids to wear a mask is, what's the other option? I just want my kids to be safe. Okay, clearly we know it's a disease out there called COVID. Clearly we know people who got it, have gotten it, died from it. And if they say a mask slows down transmission of it, then wear the damn mask. I don't know when this trend started, okay, but we wear long sleeve shirts and hoodies in 90 degree weather. Our producer Eddie in here with one on right now. Okay, ye got on a long sleeves and a hoodie right now. Hell, I was in here with one on last week. Was I comfortable when I went outside? Hell no. Got in the car and put the AC on low, okay? Didn't even have the temperature, just low, freezing, all right? But y'all talking about a mask makes you uncomfortable? Listen, choices, okay? That's what we make here, people, choices. We choose to do these things. I've seen white people wear shorts in the winter, okay? But y'all saying masks make you uncomfortable, all right? Now, on the other side is James Akers, okay? James Akers is from Texas, and he absolutely believes in wearing a mask. In fact, he was at a school board meeting in Texas, and he wanted to prove that we all follow certain rules for a very good reason. Let's go to WXAN NBC 36 for the report, please.
The furor over masks led to an unexpected moment at last night's Dripping Springs ISD board meeting.
It's simple protocol, people.
This is parent James Akers. He decided to strip down to his underwear at the microphone to make a point. He also outlined all the different laws and social expectations in place people are expected to follow, whether they like them or not. Masks, he says, are one of those things people should abide by in the effort of doing the right thing for the safety of others. We caught up with him fully clothed today.
There's too many voices out there that I think are digging in for political reasons and absolutely just not thinking about the common sense decisions we make every day to comply with everything.
Do we have audio of James Akers at the school board meeting?
I'm here to say that I do not like government or any other entity, just ask my wife, telling me what to do. But sometimes I got to push the envelope a little bit, and I just decided that I'm going to not just talk about it, but I'm going to walk the walk. At work, they make me wear this jacket. I hate it. They make me wear this shirt and tie. I hate it. On the way over here, I ran 3 stop signs and 4 red lights. I almost killed somebody out there. But by God, it's my roads too. So I have every right to drive as fast as I want to, make the turns that I want to. I got over here to the school today and the parking lot's full, and I decided I was going to park wherever the hell I want to, which in this case happened to be a handicap. But I really hate my clothes. So it's simple protocol, people. We follow certain rules. We follow certain rules for a very good reason. Can you stop?
Mr. Akers, I understand. I believe you're a swimmer, but if you would mind putting your pants back on for a comment, that would be appreciated.
He's pro-mask.
Oh, my gosh.
James Akers made a choice to script down at a school board meeting because he wanted to prove why folks should wear a mask. I can't even make this kind of stuff up. But listen, all choices, all right? Wearing a mask is a choice. Scripting down to your underwear at a school board meeting is a choice. They are all choices. But here's the thing for me and why we are here for Donkey today. See, people who are pro-vaccine, pro-mask, sound just as nuts as people who are anti-mask, anti-vaccine. These two situations, James Akers of Texas and Dan Bowman of Florida, one is anti-mask, one is pro-mask, but both of them are doing nut-ass things to prove their point. What makes it harder, okay, it makes it harder for a lot of people to choose what to do. I don't know who's right or who's wrong here. All I know is you, as in you listening, me, as in me talking, we all have to make our individual choices. We have to use our discernment to make choices based off the circumstances that are presented to us when it comes to wearing masks in establishments that aren't yours. You have the right to choose based on what the owner of said establishment mandates. I'm not protesting at a school about said school having a mask mandate, and I'm damn sure I'm not going to get in a fight with a student over it. And I'm not scripping at a school board meeting down to my underwear and running red lights and almost killing people to prove why people should wear masks either. What I'm basically saying is all of this is making us crazy, okay? Everybody, regardless of what side you are on, folks are going mad, okay? If you're pro-mask, pro-vaccine, don't let these people who are anti-mask and anti-vaccine make you go nuts. And if you anti-mask, anti-vaccine, don't let people who are pro-mask and pro-vaccine make you go nuts, because here's what it all boils down to, people. You are free to make whatever choice you want, but you are not free from the consequences of those choices. Only thing I pray for, in the words of the late, great Nelson Mandela, may your choices reflect your hopes, not your fears. But man, everybody's doing a lot of fear-mongering nowadays. Please let Remy Ma give James Akers and Dan Bowman the biggest hee-haw.
Hee-haw, hee-haw. You stupid motherfucker, are you dumb? All right. Well, Charlamagne, thank you for that donkey today.
Mm-hmm. I wear a mask, by the way.
Worked yourself up into a sweat over there.
Hey, man. You know, all of this is making everybody go crazy.
Donkey Today is brought to you by the law office of Michael S. Lamonsoff. Don't be a donkey. Dial #250 on your cell and say the bull if you've been hurt in a construction accident. That's #250 from your cell and say the bull.